In this video, we'll be reviewing the quotient property of exponents, which states that a to the power of m divided by a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m minus n. So if the bases are the same and we're dividing, we subtract the exponents, it's always going to be the exponent of the numerator minus the exponent of the denominator. And one more thing we should recognize is, in this simplified form, if we wanted this to be a fraction, we could put this over 1. So when we apply this property, the result would be in the numerator. Looking at our first example, we have y to the 6th divided by y to the 4th. So we'd have y to the 6 minus 4 power, or y to the 2nd. Now, if we're ever not sure about this rule or want to verify our work, we can just expand each of these expressions. Y to the 6th would be 6 factors of y. And y to the 4th would be 4 factors of y. Every time we have a y over a y, that would simplify to 1. So this would be a 1, this would be a 1, this would be a 1, and this would be a 1. Notice how the result would be y squared over 1, or just y squared. Looking at the second example, we can view this like two problems. We need to simplify the fraction 18/24, and then simplify x to the 9th divided by x to the 5th. So 18 over 24, these both have a common factor of 6. If we don't recognize that, we could write everything out in prime factored form. 18 is 2 times 9, and 9 is 3 times 3. 24 would be 4 times 6. Well, there's 4, and there's 6. And now we can see the common factors of 2 and 3, leaving us with 3/4. So here we have 3 over 4. And then we have x to the 9th divided by x to the 5th. So we subtract the exponents. 9 minus 5 is 4, so we'd have x to the 4th. And as I mentioned before, it would be in the numerator. So we have 3x to the 4th all over 4. Or if we wanted to, we could also write this as 3/4 x to the 4th. These two would be equivalent. And then for the last example, we need to simplify the fraction 25/35, a to the 5th over a to the 5th, and b to the 12th over b to the 10th. So starting with 25/35, these both have a common factor of 5. So this simplifies to 1, so we're left with 5/7. And now we have a to the 5th divided by a to the 5th. Well, we should recognize that anything divided by itself is going to be equal to 1. Notice if we didn't recognize that and we tried to apply the quotient property, we would have a to the 5 minus 5, which would be a to the 0, which by definition is equal to 1. But let's take a look at why this has to be equal to 1. If we wrote these out in expanded form, a to the 5th would be 5 factors of a, and so the denominator. And we know a over a would equal 1. So all of these simplify to 1, leaving us with 1. So this is the reason why a to the 0 is equal to 1. So having a factor of 1 won't change anything. So now we have b to the 12th divided by b to the 10th. So we'd have b to the 12 minus 10 power, which would be b to the 2nd in the numerator. Or if we wanted to, we could write this as 5/7 b to the 2nd. I hope you found these examples helpful.